All right, here we are. We're getting fall. It's cold out, so I've got my rugby shirts on and broke them out. My long sleeve shirts, getting ready for the cold coming. All right, so let's talk about this today. Okay, I don't hold off because the people that are on don't like waiting for other people, and I understand that. So as you get on, if you miss the first part, go back and get the replay. I think you'll enjoy this. So for those of you coming on right now, please share this out. Like it, heart it, frown on it, wow it, whatever. Good morning, Todd. Good morning, Danny, Shelley. I will swap you in a minute. You know, Todd is in Georgia, I believe, right? And I would love to have the warm weather. Although, today, the one thing about North Idaho, I'll tell you, is I love the fact that we've got the indigenous trees that, you know, have all the colors and everything, but we've got a lot of pine. So in the wintertime, even if it doesn't snow necessarily, it's still green all over the place. So you don't get that brown, depressing, you know, look that's going on. And I apologize, these are not my glasses. My little puppy, 132-pound, 8-month-old Newfoundland, has developed an affinity to eating glasses. He's eaten all my wife's glasses pretty much. Now she's had LASIK surgery, so she doesn't have to worry about it. But a couple of days ago, he ate my glasses. And so now I've got to wait I'm going to get a new eye exam anyways and get a new pair of glasses. I think I've got an appointment the first week in November there, so a couple of weeks away. So these are just readers that don't work very well. So good morning, Christopher, Alabama. Okay. He found a new he's been doing this since he was a puppy. He ate her $1,000 glasses. Which prompted us to, you know, go get her LASIK surgery anyways, which she's just loving. So anyways, let's talk about the law of sowing and reaping, right? Whatever you reap, that's what you're going to sow. If you sow in nothing, you'll reap nothing, right? So, the inverse of that is whatever you reap, it's because of what you've sown. You need to understand that, right? You need to understand that what you're reaping right now in your life is because of what you've sown. We always look at this law in kind of the normal view would be, you know, I've got to go out there and sow all this stuff so I can reap this. But when you start to analyze and look at your life, you say, oh, wow, why is this happening to me? And I look back and I say, oh, okay, it's because I've sown this. That's why I'm reaping this, okay? So, and Jim Rohn is one of my all-time mentors. I've been following him since I found out about him. I don't know if it was back in the 80s or 90s or 70s when I started. But he's been around a long time, and obviously he's passed away now, so he's not around. But his training is still as timeless as ever. And I want to give to you, I watched one of his trainings the other day, and this just really hit home. I've always known about the law of sowing and reaping, but he gave me seven properties or points to it that I want to share with you guys today. So I didn't come up with these. They make sense. They're awesome truths. But I got to give the credit to Mr. Jim Rohn, the amazing, amazing man. So let's go through these. There's seven of them, okay? And some of them you're going to go, oh, man, that makes sense, but I never thought of it that way, all right? So good morning, Jane. Good morning, Rhonda. Yulia, good to see you. Carlos Martinez, amazing, amazing servant leader. Let's get to it. Number one. The law is negative. You're going, no, not negative. Jim Rohn talking about negative. Yeah, it is negative. And here's the negative part of it. If you sow bad, you're going to reap bad, right? If you sow weeds, you can't expect to get pumpkins or corn or vegetables, right? If you sow thistles, you're going to get thistles, okay? So that's point number one. Property number one of the law is that it is negative. If you sow bad, you're going to get bad, okay? Here's property number two, though. The law is positive, right? If you sow good, you're going to get good. Here, this is the universal law that is one of those things that is kind of a bonus for us, right? If I take a cup of corn, and we used to do this, a cup full of seeds of corn, right? Of corn, right? Because that's what you're going to plant. I remember growing up on a farm as a child, we used to, you know, plow the furrows, and then you wouldn't just put one seed in there. You just go through and lay the seed out, put a ton of seed out there. But the cool part about it is all of that seed could maybe, you know, fill up a gallon bucket. But in the fall, what we reaped was significantly more than that, right? Rows after, we used to plant an acre of corn, rows after rows after rows of corn, right? And then obviously when you harvested all the corn, you got a lot more than a bucket. You got, you know, a lot of corn. So this is one of the kind of the bonuses is that if you sow good, you reap good, right? Okay, so this brings us into number three. The law is more, meaning that if you always reap more than what you sow. And this goes both on the positive and the negative side, unfortunately, right? If you sow some negative, you're going to get a lot more negative. If you sow some positive, you're going to get a lot more positive. Now, there's a direct relationship on these examples of farmers in sowing and reaping. That's what you think of most of the time. And our business. If you're out there sowing a lot of good juju, right? Good vibes. You're sowing good connections. You're out there doing your business and you're sowing a lot of seeds. What you're going to reap back from it is going to be tenfold. Right? Because you spend that time sowing and one person comes on and that person may end up being a super affiliate in your company or whatever it might be, right? And at the end of the day, make you a lot of money compared to that little bit of sowing that you did in the beginning, right? Exactly, Todd. A seed will produce its like kind every single time. Can't get a watermelon from a kernel of corn. Ain't going to happen no matter how much you want it to, right? No matter what you do. Now, I love it that people say, well, what about the ones that are genetically modified? Well, they're genetically modified. So they're modified to give you this. So they're still getting what they're designed to. There's DNA in that. There's the instructions within every seed, within every human being, and so forth. When a man and a woman get together, at the end of the day, they don't produce puppies, okay? It's just the way it is. So we have positive, we have negative. We have negative, we have positive. Number three is we have more. You're always going to reap more than you sow, whether it's positive or negative, right? So remember that. Number four is the law is versatile. There are many, many ways to sow and reap. And I love this, especially if you live in the United States. There's no excuse. Man, there are many ways to connect with people in your business. There are many ways to reach out to them. There are many ways to present, you know, your offer and your opportunity. There are many ways technically. There are many ways to get capital if you're trying to start a business. There are many ways to do everything that you need to do to sow and then reap, right? So the law is very, very versatile. You have all kinds of opportunities, and there are many ways to get there. Even if you live in a country that is, you know, depressed and going through bad times and all these other things, the ways may be less, but there's always a way. There's always a way. Okay. So number five, the law is for anyone, right? And I love this. Anyone can sow and reap, but not everyone will. It's the difference between can and will, right? In our business, anyone can sow the right processes and reap the right harvest, right? Reap an amazing harvest, become 5K, 10K, 25K affiliate, on and on and on, right? Anybody can do that, but not everybody will do it. That's the difference. Anybody can, but not everybody will. And we talk about this with our team all the time. It's not a matter of can you do it? Because everybody can do it. It's a matter of if you will do it. If you'll pay the price, if you'll do what you need, if you'll fall in love with the process, divorce yourself from the results, and just start sowing. You don't have any control of what comes out of the ground, right? As a farmer, we would plant the seeds, and then we would do what we needed to do, right? Follow up. We would do the watering, the weeding, and do everything we could. After that, there's nothing more we could do. We couldn't go to the ground and boom, corn out, or pull the pumpkins out, pull the green beans out, you know. There's nothing we could do. It was out of our hands. And your business is the same way. You can only do the process. You can do the sowing, and you can harvest what you reap, but you can't control the reaping, okay? So, number five is law is for anyone, okay? Number six is the law is a plan you could lose at, right? The law is a plan you could lose at. What does that mean? That means that you might have the best crop in the world, and the day before you're sending out the combines and you're sending out all the people to harvest that huge crop, a hailstorm, what are those things called? Boll weevils, whatever, right? Sweeps across your property, sweeps across your crop, and boom, it's all gone. You have no control over that. So sometimes, even if you sow and you're about ready to harvest what you've reaped, something bad can happen and you can lose at it. This is just a bare honest truth. And I'm going to, if Carlos is still watching, he'll laugh at this, but just trying to be real here. Just trying to be real, right? It's just the truth that sometimes you're just going to lose at it. No matter what you do, even when the harvest comes up and you've reaped what you've sown, it's right there and you're ready to, you know, harvest your crop. Sometimes before you get to it, something happens, right? We've had in this particular month, all of a sudden we had a number of people that, you know, for some reason have fallen off and so forth. And it's caused our volume to fluctuate a little bit. It happens. Doesn't mean we weren't sowing. Doesn't mean we don't continue to sow, because now everything's back on track and we're starting to explode again. You just keep going, okay? Number seven is, the law is, and this kind of ties it all together, if you don't sow, you don't reap. Okay, so that's just kind of I love what he put this in the end, and it is one of those things that it kind of ties it all together, the summary. If you don't sow, you don't reap. If you do sow, you will reap. Hey, Lily, it's up to you what you do. But if you don't sow, I guarantee you, you're not going to magically reap anything. And I get people like this all the time. You know, they get in the business, and all of a sudden it's like, okay, you know, I'm in the business. How come nothing's happening? You know, how come my business isn't growing? What's going on here? Thank you so much, Todd. You need to understand that without sowing, there is no reaping. It's not only a law; it's a biblical law. It's a scriptural law. It is a law in nature. And understand, too, you have no control over what comes up when you sow. How many of you have been in business and you've sown and sown and sown, and then the most likely people end up joining and becoming superstars? Over the last 40 years, it's happened so many times. People that you think, oh man, they're not going to do anything, and then they end. And then you've got the people that you think, man, they are going to kill this thing, and then they don't. Right? We're seeing that already now. Oops, excuse me, too close. So you don't have a control over that. You don't have a control over, you know, who, what the final result is. But you have a control over the sowing. How much you sow. Again, a good example. Hey, Daniel, a good example is that when, as kids growing up on the farm, we didn't go out and plant one seed. You know, one seed, one seed, one seed. We just laid the seeds out, you know, dug the furrows and then laid the seeds out. Ton of them, right? Because you don't know how many of those seeds that you sow, excuse me, are actually going to fertilize, grow, and pop out of the ground. And then what we had to do was we had to thin them. Because if the corn gets too close, it doesn't grow properly. So you have to either go in there and pull every other one out, or thin it out so that they're far enough apart where they can grow properly and all of that stuff. You've got to thin the crops. Sometimes your team needs thinning. There are people that, you know, either are bad influences, negative people and so forth, or there are people that just aren't doing anything. You know, and attrition is what we call thinning, nature's way of thinning, right? It's that attrition, that natural fall off. But again, all you can do is sow. Understand that. Sow and harvest. What comes up for you to reap in that harvest, you have no control over. And I liked what Todd said. Dr. Todd said is, you know, seed will produce in like kind. There's just no, if you are out there sowing seeds of negativity and so forth, you're going to reap a bunch of negative people. Hey, Elena. You're probably going to sit back and go, I don't get it. You get all these people that are so negative, you know, and you're out there just throwing up negative all over people, right? Does that that's law number that's point number one of the law. The law is negative. If you sow bad, you reap bad. Because it can't change, right? It can't you can't sow bad and expect it along the way while it's being nurtured and it's being fertilized and watered and everything to change and come up pumpkin when you sow put a corn seed in the ground. It just doesn't happen. Okay. It's like popcorn, right? Not I love that. It is exactly like popcorn. They start coming up. You just keep sowing. And as they come up, right? I love that, Elena. Absolutely. Whatever you sow, you'll get a harvest. Sow good seeds, you get a good harvest. Sow bad seeds, you get a bad harvest, right? It's not rocket science. It is just the law of nature and God's laws, right? Whatsoever a man sows, so also shall he reap, right? You just got to understand that you only have control over one part of that law. And that's the sow part of the law. You don't have control over what comes up. Whatever you sow, it's going to come up on the other end. You can't stop it, change it, modify it, make it better, make it worse. It's just what it is. Now, when you're sowing it and going through that process, the sowing of the seed includes all the watering, the weeding, the fertilizing, the you know, keeping it until it actually gets to the point for harvest, right? Old maize in the Jiffy Pop. Hey, Donna Ray, good to see you, Jason. So, I hope this has helped you. I know, you know, this is one of my shorter ones, but it's important. It's important for you to know how important this law is. It's the basis for everything that you do in your life. If you're out there sowing hate and discontent, you're going to spend a life reaping hate and discontent. It's not going to change into, you know, rainbows and unicorns. It's not going to happen, right? So what you want to do is be out there sowing just like which Jim Rohn said, right? The path to success is through the service of many. Just like Zig Ziglar said, you can have anything in life you want if you help enough other people get what they want. That's sowing good seed so that you can reap good harvest. Right? But you have got to do that. You have got to be out there. You've got to teach and train your team to do that. You've got to be in the game showing people that they need to sow and what they need to sow and how they need to sow it properly. And that's what this business is all about. All right. I guess I've said enough. What are the seven properties of the law of sowing and reaping, right? The law is negative. If you sow bad, you'll reap bad. The law is positive. If you sow good, you'll reap good. The law is more. You always reap more than what you sow. That's a huge universal benefit for us. The law is versatile. There are many ways to sow and reap. On the farm, you could do it by hand, or you could use a machine, a tractor and a machine that laid it out for you nice and cleanly also, right? Number five, the law is for anyone. Anyone can sow and reap, but not everyone will. Understand that. Everyone can have success in your business. Not a lot will, because they don't want to pay the price. They've got excuses. They've got reasons why it's not going to work for them, but the reality is that it can. It can work for everybody, without question. If it's worked for one, it can work for two. If it's worked for two, it can work for 100. If it's worked for 100, it can work for 1,000, right? But not everybody will. Number six is the law is a plan you could lose at, right? Again, crop comes up before you get a chance to reap it, before you get a chance to harvest it, I mean, storm comes. Just the way it is, man. Not all the time, obviously, but sometimes that happens. And number seven, the culmination is the law is if you don't sow, you don't reap. If you do sow, you reap. If you don't sow, you reap. You don't reap. So you got to be out there. The moral of the story is you have got to be out there sowing seeds every day. I love Robert Hollis when he's talking about making connections. You've got to be out there making connections every day. Making connections with people. Making new connections with people. Every single day. Making deeper and more solid connections with your team. Just every day be out there sowing more seeds. So I hope this is giving you some insight, giving you some excitement. Share this out with your team. Like it, heart it, frown on it, sad it, mad it, whatever you want to do. But give it some love, I hope. And God bless you. I can't wait to see you on the next one. Now, for those of you who are on our team, or not even on our team, in our company, my Saturday training for this week we're cutting our Saturday training to twice a month now. But for this week, we are going to have a special guest, the amazing Mr. Robert Hollis is going to join us on Saturday morning. And that's a lot for him, because right after we get done with ours, he does his tribe training. But he's agreed to jump on, and I'm going to open this up to everybody and anybody that's in our company that wants to learn. So if you want that link or want to find out about it, just reach out to me. God bless you all. See you on the next one.